Hi, I'm Cole from Mailchimp. In this video, I'll show you how WooCommerce and Mailchimp can help you build better relationships and drive sales. Our integration syncs your WooCommerce data to Mailchimp, including orders, customers, and products. So, you can use Mailchimp's pre-built segments and automations to personalize your marketing at scale. Before we get started, here are some important things to know. To use this integration, the WooCommerce plugin has to be installed and activated in WordPress. Keep in mind that Mailchimp for WooCommerce is a separate plugin. For more details on technical requirements, check out our help article, Connect or Disconnect Mailchimp for WooCommerce. Now that I've covered what you need to get started, let's install and activate the Mailchimp plugin in WordPress. After you log into WordPress, go to Plugins and click Add New Plugin. Then, enter Mailchimp into the search bar to find Mailchimp for WooCommerce. Next, click Install Now. And once the installation is finished, click Activate. Nice work. Now that you've activated the plugin, let's connect your WooCommerce store to Mailchimp. From your WordPress admin dashboard, click Installed Plugins. If that doesn't take you to the Connect Accounts step, click Settings in the Mailchimp for WooCommerce listing. Next, click Connect Account, and you'll be prompted to enter your Mailchimp credentials. After you've logged into Mailchimp, take some time to review the connection details. If everything sounds good, click Allow. Once the connection is made, you'll review your sync settings. To choose the Mailchimp audience you want to sync to WooCommerce, use the Linked Audience dropdown. Now, I'll cover import customers for the initial sync. Here, you'll decide what status should be applied to your historical customers who will be imported to Mailchimp. By historical, we mean customer data that's already been collected and stored in WooCommerce. Another thing to note is that WooCommerce doesn't keep track of the subscriber statuses in this section, but you'll be able to track them in Mailchimp. If you want to import all of your customers to Mailchimp as subscribed, choose Sync as Subscribed. If you'd like to import all of your customers as non-subscribed, choose Sync as Non-subscribed. But if you only want to sync WooCommerce customers who are currently in your Mailchimp audience, choose Sync Existing Contacts Only. Up next, the second Import Customers section is for the ongoing sync. Click the checkbox if you'd like to import new customers who have not opted into your marketing. This setting is necessary if you plan to use abandoned cart automations. We've got one more section to go, and that's Tag WooCommerce Customers. Tags can help you organize your customers and personalize your marketing in Mailchimp. For example, you might tag high-value customers as HVC. But just so you know, your tags will be applied to all customers that get synced to Mailchimp. When you're good to go, click Sync Now to pass your store data to Mailchimp. That's it. Your sync stats will appear in real time. If you're wondering how long the sync will take, it depends on how much data is in your store. You'll receive an email when the sync is finished, but you don't have to wait to get started in Mailchimp. If you're on the Sync Stats page in WordPress, click Continue to Mailchimp. But if you're already logged into your Mailchimp account, head to Integrations and click Manage. Then search for WooCommerce and click on the listing for the integration. Once you reach the WooCommerce integration page in Mailchimp, you'll find an overview of sync stats. If you need to adjust sync settings like shopping cart activity or non-subscribed contacts, go to WooCommerce settings. And you can use integration settings to edit a pop-up form or turn on double opt-in. Now, let's explore what you can really do with this integration. There are suggestions for next steps, like turn on abandoned cart reminders. You'll also notice some pre-built automations. We call these pre-built journeys, and you can edit them in our customer journey builder. I think these are a good way to get started quickly, and they'll help you reach the right customer at the right time. Your access to some journeys depends on your Mailchimp plan, so stop by our pricing page for details. If you want to review more options, click View All Pre-built Journeys for WooCommerce. Then, click on the journey you'd like to use. I'll choose Engage Customers who have not made a purchase in X months. After you click on a journey, you'll get a preview of the customer journey map, which shows the paths your customers can take. Just as a friendly reminder, in Mailchimp, your contacts are your customers. If you're happy with the map, click Use This Journey. Then choose your audience and click Continue. This will take you inside the Customer Journey Builder. The map begins with a trigger that we call a starting point, and the rest of the map has other journey points, like send an email. Everything is customizable, so you can add and edit journey points to meet your needs. I won't go over email design in detail, but I do want to mention our templates. So I'll click Create an Email and go to Select a Template. We've got a large library of email templates to choose from. And if you want a more custom look, you can use Creative Assistant to automatically create designs based on your branding. Before I wrap up automations, there's one more important point I'd like you to know. Your contacts can only enter an active journey map, so don't forget to click Turn On to activate your map. Now, let's return to the WooCommerce integration page and talk about pre-built segments. These help you target specific customers based on their unique qualities and behaviors. And because the conditions are preset, you could save yourself some time. To get started, just click on the segment you'd like to work with, and I'll click on Repeat Customers. Then, in the Segment Builder, you can use the dropdowns to change the conditions, and you can add more filters. Once you're ready, click Review Segment, and follow the steps to finalize it and build your message. In my case, I'd create a post-sale email to cross-sell some related products. And with that, I've shown you how to connect WooCommerce to Mailchimp. And I hope you got some ideas for how to use Mailchimp to personalize your marketing. Thanks for hanging in there. For next steps, try building a pop-up form. And I encourage you to test out some of our automations. If you have questions on our WooCommerce integration, visit our Help Center and YouTube channel for more tutorials.